Section 1 of The National Geographic Magazine, Volume 9, May 1898, November 2020. The Philippine Islands, Part 1, by F. F. Hilder. To the southeast of the continent of Asia lies a vast archipelago, of which a considerable portion is occupied by the group called the Philippine Islands, or, in Spanish, Islas Filipinas. The number of islands included under this denomination is not definitely known, and this uncertainty has given rise to some rather wild guessing. Some English authorities state the number as 600, while a late consular report issued by the Department of State places the number at 2,000, but this may perhaps be intended to include the Marianas or Ladrones, the Carolines, and the Palau Islands, as all of these are included under the jurisdiction of the Governor-General of the Philippines. Some of the Philippines are mere islets, too small for occupation, but others are important in size and resources and are very populous. The principal islands rank according to size in the following order: Luzon, Mindanao, Palawan, Samar, Panay, Mindoro, Leyte, Negros, Cebu, Bohol, and Mascato. The northern island, Luzon, on which Manila, the capital, is situated, is the largest, having an area of about 41,000 square miles, corresponding in size to the state of Ohio. Mindanao, the southernmost island, contains about 37,500 square miles. As no accurate survey of even the larger islands has ever been made, it is impossible to make a definite statement as to the aggregate land area of the group, but the most reliable estimate is 114,356 square miles, which is equal to the combined area of New York, New Jersey, Pennsylvania, and Maryland. The islands are situated directly on the line of volcanic energy which extends from Japan to Java, and volcanic forces have largely contributed to their formation and shaping, as is testified not only by the existence of active volcanoes, but by the still larger number of mountains which show evidences of former igneous activity, the traces of its effect on the surrounding country, and the abundance of thermal springs which are found in different localities, in which the temperature of the water ranges from 180 degrees Fahrenheit to the boiling point. Although situated in a region peculiarly adapted to the growth of corals, they do not exist to any great extent on the coasts of the Philippines. Occasional traces, sometimes amounting to a fringing reef, are met with in favorable places along the west coast of Luzon and some of the other islands of the group. This scarcity of coral formation may be accounted for by the presence of volcanic fires and the occasional deluges of hot water emanating from their outlets, which prevent the growth of the polyps. All the islands are generally hilly and mountainous, but none of the summits much exceed 8,000 feet in height. The loftiest peaks are, perhaps, Apo and Malindang in Mindanao, Halcon in Mindoro, and Mayon in Luzon. The latter is an active volcano, which has been the scene of several disastrous eruptions within the past 100 years. As a consequence of these subterraneous forces, earthquakes are frequent and violent. An English writer says, "The destructive ravages and changes produced by earthquakes are nowhere more remarkable than in the Philippines. They have overturned mountains, they have filled up valleys, they have desolated extensive plains, they have opened passages for the sea into the interior and from lakes into the sea." That this is not an exaggeration is proved by historical records, which contain many accounts of such disasters since the Spaniards first occupied the territory, and proofs that they have produced great geographical changes. Quote, "In that of 1627, one of the most elevated of the mountains of Cagayan disappeared. In 1675, in the island of Mindanao, a passage was opened to the sea, and a vast plain was emerged. End quote. The more recent of these convulsions occurred in 1863 and 1880, both of which caused great destruction of property. In the former, the loss of life was greater, but the more massive buildings in the old city of Manila suffered more during the latter, the cathedral and many other edifices being completely wrecked. As a result of these repeated experiences, the style adopted in the erection of buildings, especially of the better class of dwellings and stores, has been modified to meet these emergencies. Consequently, the liability to destruction and damage has been lessened. The islands are all well watered by rivers, streams, and lakes. Many of the latter are of large size, particularly the Laguna de Bay Lake, which nearly bisects the island of Luzon. Mindanao derives its name from an Indian phrase indicating the abundance of its lakes. In consequence of the island of Luzon having the capital and a very large proportion of the white residents located upon it, the interior is better known than that of many of the other islands. Its scenery, although mountainous, is charmingly diversified and will compare favorably with any of the countries of farther Asia. Its large lakes and rivers, broad plains and fertile valleys, teeming with luxuriant tropical vegetation and noble forests, add both to its beauties and productive capabilities. Animals. If a land connection ever existed between the Philippines and Borneo, the separation must have occurred long ages ago. It is true that the strait between them is narrow, but the water is very deep, and the larger animals included in the fauna of Borneo are not found in the Philippines, especially the elephant, tapir, and orangutan. There are no beasts of prey in the Philippines except a small one, el gato del monte, a species of wildcat, and even that is not very plentiful. The wild animals are buffalo, not the bison of our western plains, miscalled buffalo, but the East Indian animal, deer, hogs, which are doubtless descendants of domesticated animals that have taken to wild life in the woods, and monkeys. There is also report of the existence on the island of Mindoro of a mysterious animal called tumarao, which the natives describe as a cross between the buffalo and deer. The tamed buffalo, called the water buffalo, from its delight in wallowing in water and mud, is the most useful of the quadrupeds, and is universally employed in agricultural work and the transmission of freight, both as a pack and draft animal. Goats, sheep, dogs, and cats are plentiful. Flying squirrels are numerous in the forests, and bats of enormous size, frequently measuring 5 or 6 feet from tip to tip of their wings. Snakes, lizards, and other reptiles abound, also insect pests of various kinds, among which are the destructive white ants, mosquitoes, tarantulas, and other spiders of enormous size. Pigeons and domestic fowls are abundant, and there is an immense variety of parrots and other wild birds, many of which are comparatively little known, even by name, to American or European ornithologists. Climate. The extreme length of the Philippine group being from north to south, their northern extremity reaching nearly to the northern limit of the tropical zone, causes considerable variety of climate, although the general characteristics are, of course, tropical. On the western side of Luzon, where Manila is situated, the hottest season is from March to June, the greatest heat being felt generally in May, before the rains set in, when the maximum ranges from 80 degrees to 100 degrees in the shade. The coolest weather occurs in December and January, when the temperature falls at night to 60 degrees or 65 degrees, and seldom rises in the day above 75 degrees. In fact, during the months from November to February, the sky is bright, the atmosphere cool and dry, and the weather in every way delightful. Owing to the insular conditions, this region enjoys an advantage which does not extend to tropical continental areas of similar elevation, that is, a considerable range in temperature during the 24 hours, averaging from 10 to 20 degrees, which frequently affords the relief of a tolerably cool night, even in the hottest season. The following table of temperature, rainfall, etc. at Manila has been compiled by Professor H. A. Hazen of the United States Weather Bureau from observations made at the Observatorio Meteorologico de Manila. Temperature in degrees Fahrenheit. January. Mean monthly 77 degrees. Warmest month 79 degrees. Coolest month 74 degrees. Highest 91 degrees. Lowest 60 degrees. February. Mean monthly 78 degrees. Warmest month 81 degrees. Coolest month 76 degrees. Highest 96 degrees. Lowest 61 degrees. March. Mean monthly 81 degrees. Warmest month 82 degrees. Coolest month 79 degrees. Highest 96 degrees. Lowest 65 degrees. April. Mean monthly 83 degrees. Warmest month 85 degrees. Coolest month 81 degrees. Highest 99 degrees. Lowest 66 degrees. May. Mean monthly 84 degrees. Warmest month 87 degrees. Coolest month 82 degrees. Highest 100 degrees. Lowest 71 degrees. June. Mean monthly 82 degrees. Warmest month 85 degrees. Coolest month 81 degrees. Highest 98 degrees. Lowest 70 degrees. July. Mean monthly 81 degrees. Warmest month 82 degrees. Coolest month.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.